Well, so far, what we know about the details regarding this meeting is it's expected to convene at about 10 a.m. local time. Now, before the officials went off, South Korean presidential office officials here in Seoul said that there's likely three agendas that's going to be discussed in this high-level meeting, the first one being the date. Although reports have come out that it'll be sometime in April, they haven't set an exact date. The second will be the agenda, what will be discussed in the summit. And then the third one is how they'll carry out working-level discussions working up to the summit. So these are some of the details that this high-level delegation will have to iron out with its North Korean counterparts. And another thing we have to keep in mind is that this is very important for South Korea, especially because it'll be the first time a North Korean leader steps onto the south side of the DMZ. So it does look like South Korea has a lot of expectations going forward for this summit.
And there are also reports, Joseph, that North Korea may also hold a summit with Japan. Do we have any more details on that?
Well, we've heard reports out of Japanese media, and that says that North Korea has apparently agreed to hold summits not only with Japan, but Russia as well as other countries. Now, this so far hasn't been confirmed, but it could possibly be likely given that North Korean officials have visited Sweden, Finland, and we also know of the surprise visit North Korean leader Kim Jong Un made to China. But one problem is that if this isn't confirmed and if there is no summit, it could cause domestic problems for Japan, especially because Shinzo Abe has staked a lot of his security plans based on the North Korean threat. He's really advocated for the need for self-defense, especially with North Korea test firing its missiles over Japan and saying that this is a necessity. So if this summit does not happen, it could cause a lot of problems domestically for Abe.